Of your soul. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Banal na Diyos at dakilang Ama, Diyos na may likha ng langit at lupa, sa dakong ito pinupuri ka namin, nilulualhati at pinasalamatan sa iyong kabutihan at katapatan sa aming lahat. Loobin mo nawa na tunghayan kaming lahat ngayon, pagpalain ang lahat na rin sa banal mong harapan. Yaong may makaramdaman, lubos ang pagalingin sa pangalan ni Jesus. At lahat ng kahilingang itataas kayo pong tugunin sa ngalan ng Panginoon. Pagpalain higit sa lahat ang mabuting balitang ating ihatid o pangito sa amin, magbigay ng lakas sa ngalan ng Ama, ng Anak, ng Espiritu Santo. Amen and amen. Purihin ang Panginoon.
Ang Panginoon na diliwan sa pagdating niya, nagaganap ang aking Espiritu.
Si Kristo ay narito na, halika na iwasan na, tayo ay tutulungan na.
At pag-asa narito sa tuwi na nakahandang tutunan ka.
Haleluya, haleluya, lagi na siya at asa
sa hirap man at
purihin ang Panginoon. Let's take a reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3, verses 1 to 10. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 in the afternoon. Now, a man crippled from birth was being carried to the temple gate called Beautiful, where he was put every day to beg from those going into the temple courts. When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him, as did John. Then Peter said, "Look at us." So the man gave them his attention, expecting to get something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." Taking him by the right hand, he helped him up, and instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong. He jumped to his feet and began to walk. Then he went with them into the temple courts, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the same man who used to sit begging at the temple gate called Beautiful. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord. All hail King Jesus.
Before
sa inyong dalawang kamay. Kumusta na kayo dito sa Singapore?
Thank God! Happy and prosperous talaga!
Magaling na, mayaman pa, matalino, matuwid, marangal, wagas ang pag-ibig, malaya, payapa, kalooban, maging hawa at matuwid!
Thank God! Happy and prosperous talaga! Thank God! Ako'y mayaman at matalino pa!
Thank God!
Thank God! Ako ay marangal at matuwid na! Thank God! Happy! Pag-ibig ko'y wagas na!
Kumusta ka na?
Thank God! Happy! And prosperous talaga. Thank God, ako'y mayaman at matalino pa. Thank God, ako'y marangal at matuwid na. Thank God, happy. Pag-ibig ko'y
bata man matanda,
bata man matanda, nakibay-bagay pa. Pagkarinig pa nalang salita, sasabihin ko ibang-ibang isa iba. Happy and prosperous talaga!
Kumusta ka na?
Thank God, happy and prosperous talaga.
Lahat ng mayaman, taas ang kamay, sumigaw!
Thank God, happy, mayaman at matalino pa. Thank God, ako ay marangal at matuwid na.
Pagkay El Shaddai,
pagkay El Shaddai sa kanyang bigkay,
siksikliklik kumahapaw ang buhay.
Pagkay El Shaddai ang sinadagutugan.
Chak yun!
Happy and prosperous talaga!
Kumusta ka na?
Thank God, happy and prosperous talaga.
Sumigaw ang lahat ng mayaman!
Thank God, may mayaman at matalino ka.
Thank God,
at matuwid na. Thank God, happy.
Pag-ibig ko'y wagas na. Amen, pagkay El Shaddai,
pagkay El Shaddai sa kanilang bigay, sisigiling umaapaw ang buhay. Pag si El Shaddai sinunod mong tunay.
Chak yun!
Happy and prosperous talaga.
Kumusta na?
Thank God, happy.
Amen.
And prosperous talaga. Thank God, ako'y mayaman at matalino pa.
Thank God,
thank God, ako'y marangal at matuwid na. Thank God, happy. Pag-ibig ko'y wagas na.
Kumusta ka na?
Thank God, happy.
Lumulog lang ang lahat ng mga mayaman.
Thank God, ako'y mayaman at matalino pa.
Thank God,
ako'y marangal at matuwid na. Thank God, happy. Pag-ibig ko'y wagas.
Happy and prosperous talaga.
Happy and prosperous talaga.
Happy and prosperous talaga.
Thank God!
Happy and prosperous talaga!
Magaling na, mayaman pa, matalino, matuwid, marangal, wagas ang pag-ibig, malaya, payapa ang kalooban, maging hawa at matagumpay!
Purihin, purihin ang Panginoon. Okay. Please put your heads on your hands. Put your heads on your hands. Lagay ang ulo sa kamay. I will just ask you a few questions, and if you're able to answer this, you will go home filled with power. First question, why are you here? Ha? Bakit kayo naririto? Ang sagot doon ay, sapagkat wala kami doon. Amen ba? Okay. We are here because we are not there. Amen? Next question is, what do you want me to give you? Huh? Money? Who wants money? Now you listen to this gospel story because I believe this will not only open your eyes, but it will open your pockets. Are you following me?
Yes.
I will speak both in Tagalog and in English because there are some who requested me to speak English, though I don't know how to speak English. So I have prayed this morning. I said, Lord, please speak English this afternoon. So here I am speaking in English. I hope you will understand my English. At about this time, many thousand years ago, about more than 2,000 years, Peter and John went to the temple to pray. Prayer time is 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And so, it is not hard to understand why we are here since this morning, though this hall was filled, as I was observing, right at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And so this message is for everyone who are here and they are not there. Then at the temple gate, there was a man who has been lame from birth, meaning he had never experienced to stand on his own. He had never tasted to walk by himself. He is being brought there every day to ask for money. How many years? I do not know. So every day, he was there just to ask for money from people who are entering the temple to pray. All these years, his heart, his mind is only for money. But money was not able to change his life. Money was not able to change his physical condition. But one day, by the grace of God, Peter and John came, and this man, hoping for some money from Peter and John, looked at these two guys and their hands, in his hands, I believe, was being raised up before Peter. But Peter looked at him and said, "Man, you look at me. Look at me. Are you looking at me?
Yes.
Now let me ask you, what do you see?" Huh? Pangit o guwapo? What do you see? Huh? Do you see money on my face? Or do you say something else? And so, Peter, knowing what this man is up to, said, "You look at me. Money, silver, or gold, I do not have. But what I have, I give you." Then he said, In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, jump. Jump. Jump.
Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus.
Everybody jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump for Jesus.
Jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump for Jesus. Jump, 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 jump,
jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump, jump,
jump. Now, all those who jump are healed.
Amen!
Lahat na tumalon, magaling na.
Amen!
Sino ang gumaling? Ibig sabihin, ang pumasok kayo may sakit. And so, this man responding to the instructions of Peter, he stood up. His feet and ankles were made strong. He was set free from his bondage of paralysis. And on that day, he became a new man. His life was changed. This afternoon, I have prayed that everyone, wherever you came from, whether you will understand my English or Tagalog, the Word of God says, if you hear Him and believe, whatever you ask for will be given to you. Yeah. Amen ba? Okay. My question is, what did Peter possess at the time that he said, I don't have silver or gold, I don't have peso, I don't have Singapore dollar, can I believe him? But Peter said, I give you something better than gold, something better than dollar, something that will change yourself, something that will make you a new man. My question is, what was that? Anong mayroon si Pedro na ibinigay doon sa mamang lumpo na nagbago ng kanyang buhay? Ano? You listen to this because whoever you are, whatever you wish this afternoon, I guarantee you, by the Word of God, according to what is written, that what you have desired whether you are a terminal patient for cancer, today you will go home free from cancer. You agree with me? Okay. So look, this man was on an impossible condition. He was lame from birth. Nothing changed his life. Peter, what Peter had was his faith in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's go further to the Acts of the Apostles, verses 11 to 16, Acts chapter 3. While the vicar held on to Peter and John, all the people were astonished and came running to them in the place called Solomon's Colonnade. When Peter saw this, he said to them, "Men of Israel, why does this surprise you? Why do you stare at us as if by our own power or godliness we had made this man walk? The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus. You handed him over to be killed, and you disowned him before Pilate, though he had decided to let him go. You disown the holy and righteous one and ask that the murderer be released to you. You killed the author of life, but God raised him from the dead, and we are witnesses of this. By faith in the name of Jesus, this man whom you see and know was made strong. It is Jesus' name, in the faith that comes through him, that has given this complete healing to him, as you can all see." Purihin natin ang Panginoon. Purihin ang Diyos. Faith. So I'd like you to make a choice this afternoon. The choice is yours. If you make the right choice, you go home a different person. With one condition, you tell your neighbor, you tell other people that Jesus Christ is alive. Amen. Jesus Christ is alive. That Jesus Christ changes people. That Jesus Christ still heals the most incurable disease today. What do you want me to give you this afternoon? Money or faith in the name of Jesus?
Faith.
Who said faith?
Yeah.
Do you not need money?
Yeah.
Who needs money? Huh? Money first or faith first? Which comes first?
Faith.
Who says faith?
Woo!
Your faith has healed you.
Yeah.
Your faith has healed you.
Amen.
And not only that, your faith will make you even richer. Because of your faith, what Father Sitaram has been telling you about raising up something, your wallets, so that money will come, tomorrow will come.
Yeah.
Amen? Okay. Before I allow you to sit down, if ever I allow you, I'd like to share with you a very recent miracle that the name of Jesus has given. I have shared this letter many times over since it was sent to me by my best friend in Vancouver, Canada, who was diagnosed of stage 4 lung cancer. Dated February 25, 2013. Brother, it's been a while since we last met during your trip to Vancouver the last time when you and Sister Belen visited us at our place and had a wonderful time together. I would like to let you know that my journey in this life is about to come to an end. I was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer 3 days after my 63rd birthday last month. When I found out, it was quite a shock and shattering and devastating blow to me and my family. I wondered how this can happen to me, considering that I stopped smoking 30 years ago. Medically, I was even considered as a non-smoker. Life is so unpredictable indeed. And this is proof to me that only God knows and can decide when our journey in life will end. I have accepted this fate, and my only hope now is to pray and ask God, the Lord Jesus Christ, for a miracle to heal my cancer and or extend my life longer to be with my family and loved ones, as I really want to see our grandchildren grow up. Brother, this letter I write now is to let you know how much I appreciate and have always appreciated our friendship. We have known each other since the early 70s, almost 40 years now. Lady, my wife and I have always treasured your friendship, and I've always told my children and friends how good you and Sister Belen are, treating Lady and me like a brother and sister, even though you are a person of high stature now. This I will always be grateful for and remember for the rest of my life. I would have liked to call you to tell you about this news. However, I have lost my voice after my radiation treatment 2 weeks ago and can no longer hold a phone conversation. I hope to talk to you if and when my voice hopefully recovers in the future. I will be receiving my initial biologic treatment chemo next week. Please pray for me. Your friend, Wilkie Shia. I know that some of you have heard this story many times over the internet, but I'd like you to remember one word in his letter. When all things are gone, hope for the best. When everything is almost at the end, there is one thing that is better than any kind of prescription medicine, and that is hope in the Lord Jesus Christ. Tasan yung dalawang kamay. I read this letter in our Gawain, Manila, when I received it, and we prayed together. And I have asked our brothers and sisters in Canada, wherever they may be, to call him up. And by the grace of God, 30 days later, I received a phone call from him with his voice restored and telling me that by the grace of God, his doctors were surprised to discover that the cancer cells are disappearing. So, as I promised sometime in April, I said, friend, hold on, and I'll be visiting you before the end of June. I was there last June 20 in Vancouver, and we have our own El Shaddai Gawain right in Vancouver. And I asked him to stand up in front of God's people to share the grace that he had received from the Lord Jesus Christ. We had a long story that night for the Gawain, and he told me what happened. After our prayers together worldwide, he received a phone call past midnight. But he was not able to answer it right away. But the following morning, when he got up, there was a message left saying, "Your miracle is on the way." Somebody called up saying, "Your miracle is on the way." And that word encouraged him further. And he said, "Indeed, with God, nothing is impossible." So before we left for Los Angeles, 1 week later, after June 20, he was rushing to the airport. He almost missed us because he said, "I was caught in the traffic and the police held me up and penalized me." I said, "Why?" "Because I had my phone right on the traffic, calling my children to tell them the good news that my doctor said, you are free. You are free." In other words, Jesus has set him free from that devastating stage 4 lung cancer. This story is common in the Bible, and it is still common today. What the secret all about is what I am going to share with you, which most of us do not realize. Yes, we all need money. That's why we are here, to work for money. Yes, we all need homes to live. We all need clothes to wear. We need money to sustain our family. But the scripture says, don't worry for money. Don't worry for your food. Don't worry for your clothes. You know why? Because God, our God, knows that we need all these things. He knows who you are. He knows what you are going through. He knows what you need today. And He is able and willing to supply all your needs. There is only one condition. He said, instead of worrying what will happen to you, instead of worrying for all your needs, you seek me first. Look for me. You may not see me, but I am just here. In one of my meditation, I received a revelation which is not very common to this ministry. Jesus said, according to Matthew, "Wherever two of you or three come together in my name, there am I in the midst of you." So when two, just two, or three, come together in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus is with us. So, kasakamay niya. What does that mean? If you believe that God is with us, that means power. the power of God is with us. His presence is power. So I said, you may not agree with me, but in the language of the Spirit, 1 + 1 = 3. And that's power.
1 + 1 = 3 kapangyarihan ito.
Power! 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 Manalo ka! Praise the Lord! Come on! Power! Bring the money!
We have mighty shout, we now declare. Power! 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 1 + 1 = 3. Mighty shall we now declare. Power, power, power. 1 + 1 = 3. Lord,
we don't mind the shout.
We don't mind the shout. We now declare. Power, power, power. 1 + 1 = 3. Lord,
we don't mind the shout.
We don't mind the shout.
Let's declare.
Power, power, power. 1 + 1 = 3.
By the power of the cross,
by the power of the cross, you gave us healing and salvation. By the power of the Lamb, you brought us into your perfection. By the power of the blood of the Lamb, you overlap to your divine protection. With a mighty shout, we shall we now declare power, power, power? 1 + 1 = 3. Lord,
by the power of the cross,
by the power of the cross, you gave us healing and salvation. By the power of the hand, you brought us into your perfection. By the power of the blood of the Lamb, you covered us in your divine protection. Shall we now declare
power, power, power,
power? 1 + 1 = 3. Lord,
with a mighty shout,
with a mighty shout,
lahat ang pinagaling kumulupan.
Power, power, power. 1 + 1 = 3. Lord,
come on everybody, with a mighty shout,
with a mighty shout, we now declare.
Okay, may I request everybody please stand up, please. Ah, nakatayo na pala kayo, no? Yun ako po, you may stand up first. Before I go on, I'd like to do this ministering about the power of God. So, those people who have witnessed how the layman was able to stand up, jump, and walk, were staring at Peter, just like what you are doing now, staring at me. And Peter said, "Why do you look at me like that? As if by our own power, we have made this man walk." And Jesus said, "It is not my own power, but the power of my faith in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth that made this man strong." In Scripture, there is what is written, God uses the things that are out of mood in this world to release His power. He uses soil, He uses flowers, He used hankies during the time of St. Paul to cure all those who were sick. But the simple handkerchief that Paul had touched and were sent. Today, I am not sending anything but the power of the Word of God. Whenever I speak anywhere on radio, on television, on rallies like this, a person who listens not to me but to the Word of God that I speak will receive that power. Yeah. Will receive that power. So tonight, I'd like you to experience this power of our faith. The key word there is believe and hope. Faith is believing what we do not see, and the reward of that faith is seeing what we believe. Are you following me? Faith is believing what we do not see, and the reward of that faith, of that believing, you will see what you believe. So, would you agree with me that same Jesus who made this man strong and walk is with us today?
Amen.
Though you do not see Him. Because He said, "When two or three of you come together in my name, I am with you." Amen?
Amen.
Now, in this ministry, we'll be celebrating our 30 years this coming year, 2014. And I have brought His Holy Father in Rome to give this ministry a special audience sometime in November. So that all of us from all over the world will converge like this at St. Peter's Square. So you will receive the special blessings from the Holy Father. Raise up your hands. Somebody said, "Are you sure, Brother Mike, the Holy Father will grant your request?" What is your answer?
Yes.
Yes. Will you be there?
Amen.
Will you be there?
Amen.
Satan says you cannot be there because it's too expensive. But if you believe, God will give you the ticket.
Amen.
Amen. Where will the money come from for your ticket? From your employers. Why? Because we will pray for them.
Amen.
That they will be blessed even more. Not only with their money, but with the faith that we have.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. I was told that you were required to bring 3 sandwiches. Those who have 3 sandwiches, you raise them up. Baka kinain nyo na yan. Ha? At yung kakainin, get your sandwiches and throw that sandwiches. I would like everyone of you to experience this power. Okay. Three sandwiches and bottle of water. Amen ba? Okay. Now, you listen to this because though it's my desire to touch every one of you, if you follow me and if you believe, I'll not be the one touching you, but Jesus Himself will be touching you. Nasundan nyo na ba? Okay. Ayan sabi ni Father Sitaram. Ha? Sabi ni Father Sitaram kung ano-anong tinatas nyo. Pero lahat ng tinatas natin dito, ginagamit ng Diyos. Amen? With His power. And later on, I will explain to you according to what is written. Okay, raise up your hands with those sandwiches and bottled water. Okay. Now you listen. Makinig kayo muna, makinig kayo. Ha? Bigla kayo nagkaingay. Bakit kayo nagkaingay? Ang sagot nung kasi, biglang nabuhay. Siyempre may buhay, maingay. Amen ba? But it's time to be quiet and it's time to make noise. First, you be quiet. Be quiet. Hallelujah. Okay. According to St. Paul, in his letter to the Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, 1st chapter, verses 27 and following, God chose to use the small things of this world, the weak things, the best things, the things that are not, things people do not realize God will use to release His power. God uses ordinary people. People have not gone to school as His instrument of His compassion, as His instrument of love, and as His instrument of power. This ministry is now on the 29th year, will be 30 years. We started with a very small group in Manila over a small radio station where we started to share the gospel that delivers power. The gospel that healed me in 1978 while I was dying of heart enlargement at the Philippine Heart Center. And this is the same gospel that Peter and John stood for. Through simple things and by my faith and your faith, God's power will be released through those things. Listen very carefully. I have no instruction to anyone here in Singapore to tell you to prepare three sandwiches. Why three? You could have prepared 22 sandwiches. You could have prepared just one or any number. But why three? Here is the message. The power of God is in number three. That's the triune God that we believe as Catholics. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is in us.
Amen.
Now, why? Is it for our own good only? No. So that through us, He will be able to display His power. Not only through me, but through you. He will be able to display His power if you will allow Him to do it. So this afternoon, I'd like you to open your minds, to open your eyes, and open your hearts to this message. If I remember right, this is the first thing we are going to do in this ministry. We will pray for the anointing of your sandwiches and for your water. One sandwich is for divine wisdom, that you may know that God is with you, that you may know that God knows who you are, that you may know that God has already healed you, that you may know that God cares for you. And above all, that you may know that He loves you, whoever you are. And that love is never affected by any of our sins. The love of God remains constant. The second sandwich stands for divine grace. Divine grace. What is grace? What is grace? It is God's goodness, unlimited. He gives and is willing to give to everyone. For out of the goodness of God, sinners are led to repentance. It was through His goodness that Brother Mike, a sinner, a gambler, whatever he was at the time, was changed to become like what I am. Ano? Takasan nyo. Ang gwapo doon, wala sa mukha. Kasi pag ako nananalamin, ay, nako. Nagugulat pa ko, paano ko niya sasabi niyang gwapo? The gwapo there is the goodness of God sinks and stays in our heart. You understand that? And out of His goodness, you will remember and reach out to that person whom you have cursed. If you have cursed anyone in your life, or if there is someone whom you cannot forgive, has been holding you back to experience God's grace, you will deliver that sandwich to him or to her. You just tell him, this is with the love of the Lord, and whatever you wish, before you eat that sandwich, God will make it happen to you. So we have two, divine wisdom. The first sandwich is for divine wisdom. That's for you. After the service, you eat that sandwich, giving thanks to God, and you can ask anything. Amen. While you are eating that sandwich, ask God to do something for you. Amen. And I believe by faith that God will make it happen to you. Amen. So divine wisdom, divine grace, and the third is divine power. Power. Say it.
Power.
Say it again.
Power.
Okay, you listen to this very carefully. Christians and Catholics most especially. This is part of the message. I think it is number 5 or 4 in the message. Tonight I'm just now preparing the message. I am just now on the introduction, not yet on the healing message. Are you following me? So, Jesus one day was hungry. So he approached a fig tree, hoping that the fig tree will have some fruits to eat. But he found nothing. When you came in here, you brought nothing to the Lord. But don't worry. You came in nothing, you will go home full of the things you need. Full of power. Full of wisdom. And full of grace. Like Mary, the mother of Jesus, the mother of our church. Full of grace. Full of power, full of grace. Now, so the first sandwich is for? Divine wisdom. The second sandwich is for? Divine grace. The third sandwich is?
Power.
Okay, you remember this power. Power is right at the tip of your tongue. Power is the right at the tip of your tongue. This is what my friend in Vancouver have exercised and discovered. In that power to heal even the terminal cancer was released through him. And this will happen to each one of you. Jesus said, I tell you the truth, if you have faith, you can do what I have done to the fig tree. What did Jesus do to the fig tree? He talked. He spoke to the fig tree. And he said, since I find no fruit in you, starting today, nobody will eat your fruit. Meaning, he cursed the tree. And right away, the tree withered. Natuyo agad yung puno ng igos. Then Peter said, look, Lord, the tree you have cursed has died. Then Jesus said, I tell you the truth. If you have faith and do not doubt, you can also talk to a tree. You can talk to a sickness. You can talk to your cancer. You can talk to your mountains of problem and let them go away. And if you do not doubt, but believe that what you have spoken will happen, God will make it happen to you. See? Now, in this ministry, as I am inspired, I transfer all these things to everyone. He who believes receives. Jesus said, if you believe, you will receive whatever you ask for in prayer. Okay, raise up your sandwiches and water. How about the water? Water is life. Most people are not sick. They are dehydrated. They lack water in the body. Because instead of water, they keep on drinking tea, drinking coffee, drinking soda. There is no more water. So the body dries up like a soil in summer. When there is no rain, the plants dies. That happens also with our body. So starting today, your body needs at least 2 liters of water a day. You ask your doctor. And if you are taking some medicines, you need more water to flush out the negatives of the medicine. Water heals. Water heals. In Exodus chapter 23, verses 25 to 26, if I remember right, this is what is written. Worship the Lord your God, and he will put his blessing on your water and food. He will take away all sickness from you.
Yes.
When you eat that blessed water and food, because you worship the Lord your God, God will remove the sickness that gets through that water and food. And this is the power I am sharing with you.
Amen.
Say the word power.
Power.
So every word you proclaim is power. The word of God is two-edged. Both sides. A two-edged sword. It has both a negative and positive effect. When you say something negative, that will have an effect with you. When you say I am sick, you will become sick. When you say you are healthy, you will become healthy.
Amen.
When you say you are strong, you will become strong.
Amen.
So when you are weak, don't say I am weak, because you will become weaker and weaker. Say I am strong.
Say
I am healed. Say,
I am healthy.
Say, I am beautiful.
I am beautiful.
Say it again.
I am beautiful.
I am pretty.
I am pretty.
Amen. If you repeat that again and again, you will become pretty. Just like Brother Mike. I've been saying I am handsome, that's why I am handsome. And finally, my wife believed that. I am handsome. Okay, let's pray. Raise up your sandwiches and water. Say, Father, who created the heavens and the earth, who knows everything that I need, who knows who I am, who knows what I need, who knows what I am going through. Right now, I declare in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, your holy begotten Son, that today I am who I am, a son or daughter. If you are a girl, daughter, huh? A daughter of the Most High. I am strong. I am healthy. I am wise. I am full of grace. I am full of power. I pray that you will bless these three sandwiches and water, and through it you shall release the power that I need today. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Sabihin niyo, okay. Say it again, okay. Say it again, okay. Ask your friend beside you, are you okay? Yeah. Are you okay? Okay. Okay, put down your sandwiches and bottled water. Put down your sandwiches and water and find a partner. Find a partner. Find a partner. Okay. Find a partner. Stand up, stand up. Okay. Hands against the hand. Oh, kamay, laban sa kamay. Oh, Father, pakituro mo yan sa bisita mo. Kamay, laban sa kamay. Ayan. Palad, laban sa palad. Find your partner. We will now exercise this power. Are you following me? Okay, when I say 1+1, you charge your hands against each other 3 times. Okay? One plus one. One, two, three. Okay. Okay, okay. Raise up your hands together. One plus one. Okay. After the third clap, you will say, divine wisdom.
Divine wisdom.
One plus one. Next, when I say 3 plus 3, you clap your hands 7 times, and at the 7th you will say, divine grace. One plus one. Teka muna, wala pa tayo sa divine grace. You wait for that. Nagmamadali yata kayo eh. Diba? First muna is 1, 2, 3, divine wisdom. When I say 3 plus 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, divine grace. Okay? Oh, ready? 1 plus 1. 3 plus 3.
5.
Okay. When I say 7 plus 7, you clap 15 times. On the 15th clap, you say, divine power is ours. Say it. Said, divine power is ours.
Divine power is ours.
Say it because the power is in your tongue. Okay? One plus one. Three plus three. Seven plus seven. 'Yan ang Panginoon. Purihin ang Diyos. Okay. Now, raise up your hands. Give yourself one. Okay. When I say 1, 2, 3, you, what you call that? Huh? You bump your foot. Huh? On your chair. 1, 2, 3. It should touch the chair. Huh? Okay. Raise up your hands. Raise up your hands. We are exercising power right now. 1, 2, 3. Okay, you sit down. Now, let me ask you, how do you feel? How do you feel? Your answer should be filled with power. Okay, you listen to this. This is very important. Some people say, you keep on joking, Brother Mike. I'm not joking. I'm sharing with you what I have discovered all these years. I've been preaching the Word of God for the last 29 years. And I have witnessed power being released in every activity. Are you following me? Do you believe God's power is with you?
Amen.
Do you believe God's power is with you?
Amen.
Okay. How do you release that power? How? Peter said to the lame man, look at me. Are you following me? Then he said, silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I give you. He spoke power. Power is right with you. That's both positive and negative power. What you are today is a product of words you have spoken before. And I would like you to change that language. When you go home, you speak words of wisdom. You speak words of grace. And you speak words of power to yourself and to the members of your family. Words are spirits. They are life. Jesus said, my words are a spirit and they are life. This is how faith works. Are you following me? I'm now sharing with you how to make your faith power work. Are you following me? Okay. For you and for others. What is the big difference between the power of money and the power of faith? Truth of the matter is, the power of money never existed. The more money you have, the more problems it brings. But the more faith you have, the more blessings you receive. Money included. There is money that do not bring trouble to a man. It is money that God freely gives. Faith says, the Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. No matter how long you pray, no matter what church you get into, and pray and pray and pray without faith in your prayer, all your prayers means nothing. You must believe when you pray that God is there, that God exists, and He rewards your prayers. Are you following? And He rewards your prayers. Last, I will ask you later on to raise up your prayer requests. Second, know that what is impossible with man is possible with God through faith. What is impossible for man is possible for God through faith. It's all by faith. It is impossible for a single person to gather thousands of people like this when you are coming from all over the place and spending your money. But by the grace of God, you never counted your expenses. You freely came in here to worship Him and to fellowship with one another, expecting that the end of the service, God is with you still. Amen ba? So if God is with us, who can go against us? With God, remember this, nothing is impossible. Amen? Third, know that what money and doctors cannot do, faith can do. Are you following me? Know that what money and doctors cannot do, your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ can do it. I have seen this beautiful picture there of a woman, representing that woman who had suffered for 12 long years of blood cancer. She was bleeding for 12 years. She had spent all her wealth for doctors and medicines for the last 12 years, but nothing good happened to her. She even got worse. But one day she heard that Jesus Christ of Nazareth was passing by, and her mind changed from hopelessness to hopefulness. From hopelessness to hopefulness. What do you think he was thinking all those years? She is going to die. Doctors have told him so. She had no more money. She spent all her money for doctors and medicines to no avail. But one day she heard that Jesus Christ of Nazareth was passing by. And she said to herself, are you following me? Amen. Sinabi niya sa kanyang sarili. She said to herself, if only I can come close to that guy and touch his clothes, I will be healed. Are you following me? The healing took place when she told herself verbally that if only she could touch the clothes of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, she will be healed. And so she got up with all the strength left with her. She got up from bed, went through the crowd, get closer and closer to Jesus Christ, just like what you did today, coming from everywhere, you exerted all effort, forgetting who you are, forgetting your possessions, forgetting everybody, just to be with Jesus today. Just to be with Jesus today. Remember, it is not Brother Mike who is talking to you. I am just his instrument of faith. I know nothing. I have not studied theology. I have not studied scriptures. I have not gone to any religion class. I know nothing about my religion. One thing I knew, what my money cannot do in 1978 at the Philippine Heart Center with 5 specialist heart doctors attending to me, none of them can guarantee if I will survive a heart attack. But one evening past midnight, a lady dressed in a nurse uniform came into my room and brought this message to me, taken from the Bible. 1 Corinthians 10:13 saying, God is faithful. God is faithful. He will never allow you to be tested and tempted beyond your power to resist. On the other hand, at the point of trials and testing, God will provide you an extraordinary strength to overcome your sickness, to overcome your weaknesses, to overcome your troubles. That happened to me. And it changed the whole of my life since then. And this is what I've been proclaiming ever since, that God, whom we do not see, is ever faithful. When He says, I will heal you, He will heal you. When He says, I will save you, He will save you. And He did just that. And so this woman came behind, saying, if I just touch the clothes of Jesus of Christ of Nazareth, I will be healed. She did touch. And once after that, Jesus knew power had been released to the woman. And Jesus asks people around Him, including His disciples, saying, who touched me? The disciples said, Lord, everybody is touching you. Why should you ask who touched you? But Jesus said, that kind of touch is different from the touch of everybody. That is the touch of faith. That was the touch of faith. Faith that woman have spoken. The power has been released from his mouth. Out of the heart, man believes, and through his mouth, he proclaims his belief. he proclaims his belief. And once you proclaim your belief, God's power is released. And that woman was healed instantly. What her money, what her doctors, what her wisdom, what her friends cannot do in one single moment when he spoke the word of faith and he did what he said. She pushed herself through the crowd to touch the clothes of Jesus Christ. The healing took place when she told herself verbally that if only she could touch the clothes of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, she will be healed. And so she got up with all the strength left with her. She got up from bed, went through the crowd, get closer and closer to Jesus Christ, just like what you did today, coming from everywhere, you exerted all effort, forgetting who you are, forgetting your possessions, forgetting everybody, just to be with Jesus today. Just to be with Jesus today. Remember, it is not Brother Mike who is talking to you. I am just his instrument of faith. I know nothing. I have not studied theology. I have not studied scriptures. I have not gone to any religion class. I know nothing about my religion. One thing I knew, what my money cannot do in 1978 at the Philippine Heart Center with 5 specialist heart doctors attending to me, none of them can guarantee if I will survive a heart attack. But one evening past midnight, a lady dressed in a nurse uniform came into my room and brought this message to me, taken from the Bible. 1 Corinthians 10:13 saying, God is faithful. God is faithful. He will never allow you to be tested and tempted beyond your power to resist. On the other hand, at the point of trials and testing, God will provide you an extraordinary strength to overcome your sickness, to overcome your weaknesses, to overcome your troubles. That happened to me. And it changed the whole of my life since then. And this is what I've been proclaiming ever since. That God, whom we do not see, is ever faithful. When He says, I will heal you, He will heal you. When He says, I will save you, He will save you. And He did just that. And so this woman came behind, saying, if I just touch the clothes of Jesus of Christ of Nazareth, I will be healed. She did touch. And once after that, Jesus knew power had been released to the woman. And Jesus asks people around him, including his disciples, saying, who touched me? The disciples said, Lord, everybody is touching you. Why should you ask who touched you? But Jesus said, that kind of touch is different from the touch of everybody. That is the touch of faith. Amen. That was the touch of faith. Faith that woman have spoken. the power has been released from his mouth. Out of the heart, man believes, and through his mouth, he proclaims his belief. He proclaims his belief. And once you proclaim your belief, God's power is released. And that woman was healed instantly. What her money, what her doctors, what her wisdom, what her friends cannot do in one single moment when he spoke the word of faith and he did what he said. She pushed herself through the crowd to touch the clothes of Jesus Christ. And after that, power was released to her. And that same power operates today. That is what we have just heard earlier. This is how faith works. Faith is not a matter of just praying. Praying is part of that faith. But unless you speak the right kind of words, your prayers are negative. Fourth, know that with faith, your words hold the key to miracles. Your words hold the key to miracles. Negative and positive words do not mix. Your faith must be focused on something that is unchangeable. And there is only one thing that is unchangeable. People's mind changes. People's attitude changes. The weather changes. Feelings change. But the word of Christ never changes. The word of Christ never changes. So, once you hear the word, Mary, the mother of Christ, our mother, keep those words in her heart. Keep those words in her heart, not in her mind, but in her heart. For out of the heart, the mouth speaks. When your heart is full of love, your language is love. When your heart is full of goodness, your language is full of goodness. When your heart is full of faith, your words are full of faith. Amen. So you, when you need a miracle, the first thing you do is to proclaim the name of Jesus. Jesus' name is above every name. There is no other name in heaven and earth powerful than Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Power and of grace, the name, for the name.
Okay, how do you operate this power? Simple. First, believe God is with you. Amen. If you believe God is with you, the first word that should come out from your mouth, wherever you are, whatever is happening to you, is that powerful name, Jesus. Amen. Say it.
Jesus.
Say it. Then the next word should be power.
Power.
Say it.
Power.
Say it.
Power.
Every time you mention that name and say power, faith turns weakness into strength. Faith, your faith will turn your weakness into strength. Power will be released to you. Hindi ka makatayo. Ha? Pag naniwala ka sa pangalan ng Panginoong Hesus, tinawag mo siya at inutusan mo ang tuhod mo na dumiritso at tumayo, dediritso yan. Amen? Ha? Lahat naman yan, dediritso talaga. Pagdating ng sandali, lahat na baluktot, didiretso. Diretso ang tuhod, diretso ang kamay, diretso ang kataman, tapos pipikit. Amen? Ano gusto nyo? Diretso na kapikit o diretso na kadilat? Dapat diretso na kadilat, ano? Hallelujah. So, with faith, our weakness is turned into strength. That is found in Hebrews 11:32-35. It says, and what more shall I say? Ano pang masasabi ko sa inyo? I do not have time to tell about Gideon, Barack Obama, Samson, Jephthah, David, Samuel, and the prophets who through faith conquered kingdoms, administered justice, and gained what was promised. Who shut the mouths of lions, quenched the fury of the flames, and escaped the edge of the sword, whose weakness was turned into strength, and who became powerful in battle and routed foreign armies. You understand my English? Yeah? Kung di nyo naintindihan, sorry na lang kayo. But I'm telling you, all of you, everybody today, are special.
Yeah.
You are special. For giving God this time, though you have some important announcement, you have given first priority to the Word of God, rather, you will go home tonight and you cannot sleep. You know why? Because that power will operate in you.
Yeah.
Amen. Then when you fall into sleep, when you wake up, this is what you should say first in the morning. Thank God for the power.
Thank God for the power.
Say it again. Okay. Now, there is one guy who will try to destroy that power if you will allow him. But never, never allow him to steal that power that you have received today. And who is that guy? Who is that guy? Who can guess? Huh? You say Satan? No. Huh? You always blame Satan. Kawawa naman ito ni Satanas. Huh? That guy is Mr. Doubt. Say it.
Mr. Doubt.
Okay, sabihin niyo, Mr. Doubt.
Today,
you're out,
of my life.
Say it again. Very good. Very good. Never doubt that God has healed you today.
Amen.
Put your heads on your shoulder. Your hands on your shoulder. Okay. Put your hands on your shoulder. Okay. Alam mo kasi, si Mr. Doubt is saying, ano ba kayo? Uto-uto. Sunod kayo ng sunod. Diba? That's what Mr. Doubt is saying. But don't mind him. No? He is out of your life already. Amen? Okay. Now, where are we now? Okay. Mr. Doubt is out of your life. Because every time you doubt, this is what will happen to you. At principal in Legarda Elementary School, this is about many years ago, about 15 years ago, we were just on the third year of this ministry, came to me with toxic goiter, very big goiter. And doctor said, we have to operate on that because it will eventually be cancerous. So she came to me, so we prayed. I was just starting this ministry at the time, and I am very obliging to touch everyone, no matter how many they were. So we prayed, and I said, today, your goiter is no more. And she said, thank God, I believe. So she went home believing that the goiter is no more. Monday came, she took a bath. After taking a bath, she went to her mirror, looked at her face, and looked at her throat, looking for the goiter. And I said, and the goiter disappeared, and said, where is my goiter? What happened to my goiter? It's no more. So she was excited. My goiter is no more. So she came to school telling her co-teacher and said, what happened to my goiter? It's no more. And the teacher said, why? What have you done? I went to Brother Mike in Makati and asked him to pray for my goiter. And he said, my goiter is no more. And when I took a bath, I look at the mirror. Indeed, my goiter is no more. So I shouted, where is my goiter? Then 1 week later, she came back to me. The goiter came back. The goiter came back. I said, Brother Mike, what happened? I said, I don't know. I said, why? What happened? Indeed, when we prayed and I believe the goiter is no more, I took a bath. When I look at the mirror, the goiter is no more. I said, what did you say when you saw that the goiter is no more? I said, where is my goiter? That's it. Raise up your hands. Raise up your hands. And you know what happened? I said, this is what happened. Your goiter is just about to exit from the door. She heard. She heard you calling for her and said, oh no, I'm not going to leave. I am her goiter. So goiter returned. You never do that. Sickness are spirits. They hear. They follow your words. Jesus' words are spirits likewise. It has power. It has life. Believe in Jesus. Believe His words. Believe in miracles.
Yeah.
Amen. That's how faith works. And finally,
kagalakan ang aking nadarama sa tuwing ako'y nakikinig ng banal na salita. Nalaman ko ang susi ng kanyang mga alibata. Sa gabay ng lingkod niya minagpala.
Jesus, I said to you, stand up and walk. Stand up and walk.
Ang buhay mo ngayon.
Amen. Sige, yeah, help me. Finally, tasangin yung mga prayer request. Okay. Sige. That's on your prayer request. Okay. That's on prayer request. Okay, mamaya maya, yung mga ibang yan. Okay. Yeah, you can live up. Dati hindi umataas yan, naitataas mo na ngayon. Very good. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's power. Okay. Raise up your hands and your prayer requests. Now you listen to this. I've been sharing with you the power of our faith. But the key to that power is what I'd like you to remember in this last message. Finally, faith comes from hearing the message. And the message is heard through the word of Christ. It is very important that we give time to the word of God. Inside the mass, there is but 10-15 minutes for the priest to deliver the message. The gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ is in itself a healing message. That's why in this ministry, every time I deliver this message, it is called a healing message. Because the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ is indeed a healing message. It heals the soul, the spirit, and the body. There's healing in the word of Christ. It is very important. This broadcast right now is coming from Topayo Sports Complex in Singapore, and we are being heard and monitored all over the world. Amen. And all those who have monitored this message this afternoon, wherever you may be, if you have opened your ears, your minds, and your hearts to the message from the beginning up to this time, that faith that delivers a person from the bondage of affliction, from the bondage of sin, from the bondage of money, is now released. Amen. By this power. So faith, the Bible says in Romans 10:17, consequently, faith comes from hearing the message. And the message is heard through the word of Christ. This is what I've been laboring this ministry for the last 29 years. Delivering this message in 2 to 3 hours without getting tired. Because my weakness, physical weakness, is turned into strength every time I deliver this message. And this strength that I receive is released to everyone who listens to this message. Purihin natin ang Panginoon. Purihin natin. Okay. Now raise up your prayer requests, your hands, and say, Lord Jesus Christ, I thank you for the message that has delivered me from my fears, from my anxieties, from my weaknesses, and from my affliction. Now I declare in your name, in your most precious, powerful name, Jesus. Jesus, that I am healed. I declare in your name, Jesus, that I am free. I declare in your name, Jesus, that starting today, I am new. 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 With power. With power. In your name, I will tell the world that Jesus, Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the same yesterday and today and forever. Amen. Say amen. Lakasan niyo. With power. With more power. Very good. Purihin, purihin, purihin ang Panginoon. Okay, raise up your hands. Kasi yung kamay. Bitawan niyo yung prayer request niyo muna. Because by faith, I will leave something to you. As Peter have said, silver or gold, I do not have. But I give you what I have. Do you agree with me? Huh? Are you going to receive this? Okay. When I open my hands and throw something, you jump for it. You receive it with power. This is what you should say with your words. Sasabihin niyo, this is power.
This is power.
Better
than gold.
Ulitin niyo.
This is power better than gold.
And what is that power better than gold?
Faith
in Jesus. Faith in the name of Jesus. Ano sasabihin niyo? Power of the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Never before have I thought I could die. Never before.